A lot of people from all over the country are thinking about moving to the Carolinas. On today's video, we're going to compare North Carolina versus South Carolina so you can decide which state is best for you. Hi, this is Chris Morton, real estate broker with eXp Realty, and on today's video, we're going to compare the Carolinas, North Carolina versus South Carolina. And because this is such an important video, we've decided to bring in a special guest to kind of break down and give his opinion. So this guest has lived most of his life in South Carolina and has recently made the move to North Carolina. So let's bring him out now and introduce him. Everyone, this is Winston, the Australian Shepherd. Winston has lived most of his 9 weeks and 3 days in the state of South Carolina, has recently made the move to North Carolina, and he's very excited to help me today break it down and give you guys some comparisons about what state is best. And what? Oh, he says if you wait until the end, he's gonna give you his opinion on which state is best. And so with that, let's get on with the video. So first, let's talk about the populations of both states. In North Carolina, you have 10.5 million people living in the state, whereas in South Carolina, there are 5.2 million people living in the state. And comparing the capital cities of both states, you have Raleigh in the state of North Carolina with about 480,000 people, and Columbia in South Carolina with about 130,000 people. The largest cities in both states are Charlotte with 890,000 people in the city and 2.7 million people in the metro area, and Charleston, which is the oldest city in South Carolina with 140,000 people in the city and around 800,000 people in the Charleston metro area. As far as the climate and the weather of both states, the climate of both states is fairly similar, with South Carolina being slightly warmer and of course North Carolina therefore being slightly cooler. But they both have hurricanes, which is a big issue you need to know about. And more than less, the weather patterns are different from east to west as opposed to the two states north to south, meaning it's warmer on the coasts and it's cooler in the mountains of both states. When comparing the foods of both states, they're fairly similar. As far as seafood goes, both states are really known for seafood. South Carolina more for shrimp and grits and low country boil. North Carolina more for fried seafood. They both have barbecue, pork barbecue. A little bit different, however. In North Carolina, there is a vinegar-based sauce and a tomato-based sauce, depending on what section of the state you're in. South Carolina is more known for an apple mustard-based sauce, and their sides are a little bit different than North Carolina, but by and large, both really, really good. And in the bigger cities in the states, you're gonna find a more varied cuisine. Obviously in Charleston, South Carolina, which is a famous tourist destination, they have a very wide and varied food scene going on there. Same with Myrtle Beach area in South Carolina, which is a major, major tourist attraction area of the state of South Carolina. You can get just about any kind of cuisine you want there. And as well in the state of North Carolina, you've got Charlotte, Raleigh, Wilmington, all the bigger cities. You're gonna be able to get just about anything you want there as well. Now moving on to taxes, South Carolina in general has a lower tax burden than the state of North Carolina. The median property tax in North Carolina is 0.77%, and the median property tax in South Carolina is 0.55%. Now, the good thing is both states are under the national average of 1.07%, so there is that. North Carolina has a flat income tax of 5.25%. South Carolina has a progressive income tax of between 0 and 7%, with 7% being anyone who makes over $15,400. Gasoline is generally cheaper in South Carolina, with the state tax being 24 cents per gallon, although that is set to rise. In North Carolina, the tax is 35.4 cents per gallon, which is one of the highest in the Southeast. Sorry, I have to interrupt this video. Winston needs to tell me something. Yes, what? Okay, I'll let him know. Winston says he's enjoying this video so much that he would like you to subscribe and hit the bell if you haven't already done so, because he plans to do future videos with us and he doesn't want you to miss any of his special appearances. So, okay, I've told him. Are you happy now? Very good. Anyway, back to the video. The GDP of North Carolina is $566 billion and is growing at 1.6% per year, making it the 19th fastest growing state in the United States. South Carolina's GDP is $248 billion and it is growing 2.6% per year. making it the 10th fastest growing state in the United States. To put that all into perspective, if North Carolina was its own country, it would be the 22nd largest economy in the world, slightly ahead of Sweden. And if South Carolina was its own country, it would be the 44th largest country in the world, slightly bigger than Egypt. The poverty rate in North Carolina is 14%, which is the 14th highest in the United States. And South Carolina's poverty rate is 15.3%, which is the 9th highest in the United States. In North Carolina, the unemployment rate is 6.2%, while in South Carolina, the unemployment rate is 4.6%. Both states are doing better than the national average, which is 6.3%. As far as the cost of living goes, according to bestplaces.net, the North Carolina cost of living is 90.6, which is 9.4 points better than the national average. And the South Carolina cost of living is 88.5%, which is 11.5 points better than the national average. The median home value in North Carolina is $226,000, while in South Carolina, the median home value is $206,000. Now, of course, this is an entire statewide, including all the rural areas. Clearly, in the bigger cities, the median home value is going to be a lot more. But this hopefully gives you an idea of what you can get for your money in the states of North Carolina and South Carolina. The median household income in the state of North Carolina overall is $57,000 a year, while in South Carolina, it's $52,000 a year. Again, just like with median home values in the bigger cities, the household income is a bit higher. Minimum wage in both states is $7.25 per hour. And both states are among the fastest growing states in the country, with both North Carolina and South Carolina in the top 10. South Carolina is growing 1.3% every year, while North Carolina is growing 1.1% every year. Numerically, North Carolina is the 5th fastest growing state in the United States, while South Carolina is the 9th fastest growing state. Geographically, both states border the ocean and the Appalachian Mountains and have reasonable access to both. Politically, South Carolina is a reliably red state, while North Carolina has historically been a battleground purple state. As far as the sports scene goes, North Carolina has some very, very top college teams like UNC, Duke, and NC State, as well as some historically black colleges like NC Central and Shaw that have really, really good basketball and football programs. In South Carolina, they have two very, very good college football and basketball schools, University of South Carolina in Columbia and Clemson University, recent national champion football team in Clemson, South Carolina. Professionally, North Carolina has the Carolina Hurricanes hockey team in Raleigh, the Charlotte Hornets NBA basketball team in Charlotte, and the Carolina Panthers NFL football team also in Charlotte. North Carolina also has a good number of minor league baseball, basketball, hockey, and soccer teams. While in South Carolina, there is no real professional teams, although they do share the Carolina Panthers with the city of Charlotte. And mostly South Carolina is known for their minor league baseball teams. There is a bit of controversy among the states of North Carolina and South Carolina. That is specifically between the University of North Carolina and the University of South Carolina. Both schools claim the name Carolina. Although having gone to the University of North Carolina, I can tell you there is really no controversy. The University of South Carolina is called Carolina, but only in the state of South Carolina. The University of North Carolina is called Carolina, also in a tiny little place called the rest of the planet. University of North Carolina has Michael Jordan, Dean Smith, on and on and on and on. We also were started about 100 years before South Carolina was. Am I throwing shade? Yes, I am. I saw a famous quote about this topic recently. If a ram, which is the mascot of North Carolina, and a chicken, which is the mascot of University of South Carolina, the Gamecocks, got in a fight, there would be a bunch of chicken feathers floating around. I'll leave it at that. As far as education rankings go, according to US News and World Report, North Carolina ranks 15th in education, while South Carolina ranks 42nd. As far as healthcare goes, also according to US News, the state of North Carolina ranks 30th and the state of South Carolina ranks 34th, although Raleigh, Durham, Chapel Hill region of North Carolina, and the Charlotte region of North Carolina are well-known medical centers in the country. As far as industry goes, both states have an agricultural economy, but North Carolina is a little bit more varied. You have banking in Charlotte and technology, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, in the Raleigh, Durham, Chapel Hill area. As far as drivers go, North Carolina can claim having the 25th worst drivers in the United States, while South Carolina can claim to have the 7th worst drivers. I would be fair and attribute a lot of that to tourists that are coming into South Carolina, Myrtle Beach, Charleston, etc. Might be causing little accidents. Having lived in South Carolina for 3 years, I can tell you, you always had to watch out for people with license plates from certain states that will remain nameless. And speaking of tourism, North Carolina has both the coast, the Outer Banks, Wilmington area, and the mountains, which are two really very popular places for people all over the country to come visit. However, South Carolina has Charleston, which is one of the most historic cities in the country. Very, very world renowned for architecture and the scenery and the amazing history of the city. As well, South Carolina has the Myrtle Beach region, which is one of the very top beach destinations in the country. So, with that in mind, you're gonna have to tip your hat to South Carolina as far as tourism goes. Finally, let's talk about the people. Generally, people in both North Carolina and South Carolina are very nice, polite, southern people. Although having lived in South Carolina for 3 years and North Carolina the rest of my life, I have to give it up to South Carolina. Generally, people are more down to earth and a little bit more friendlier in South Carolina than in North Carolina. So in general, with all of these stats and figures I've given you, you can pretty much tell both states have more in common than they have difference. So there you have it. All of the different things that are different about North Carolina and South Carolina. Yeah, there's a lot that's similar about them. And so now we have to have Winston come back and tell us which state he likes the best. What's your verdict? What do you want to do? Yeah, that makes complete sense. Winston says he likes the state with the most cookies and the most hugs. And that, of course, would be North Carolina. Yay! North Carolina wins. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been Chris Morton and Winston. We'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.